Okay. Welcome to all of you. Good morning. So we will be covering following topics in the webinar today. One, definition of composite work contract under section 2119. Exemptions and rate of tax in relation to supply out to government and governmental authority. We are covering two notifications. One is 12/2017 and 11/2017. So we will be covering few clauses that are relevant and important for the subject. An analysis of the civil structure and structure used in serial number 3 sub clause 6 of notification number 11/2017. So Pradeep ji, please start your session.
Thank you, Jeevan ji. I welcome everybody who's joined in for this webinar today, and special thanks as always to Anil ji and Pavan ji, who have been so supportive and are experts on this Sunday question and answer session that we do. What we are covering today is basically the nature of supply that is made to government, local authorities and governmental authorities and government entity. I would request everybody to kindly mute themselves. So the coverage today includes supplies provided to government, local authorities and governmental authority. Nature of supply to government, government authorities and local authorities broadly are covered under two exemptions under notification number 12/2000. Jeevan ji, if you could kindly admit everyone, please. So we'll be covering notification number 11/2017 as well as 12/2017 for the rate and the exemptions as well. Now to start with, and where does it originate? Because there is a lot of reference to Article 243, Article 243G and 243W. So I'll just take you through what, as Jeevan ji has already said, that what we are going to cover today is basically we'll have a reference to what Article 243G and 243W of the Constitution of India says, and then we'll see what is defined as a work contract in GST, and we'll take you through then the exemption notification and the rate notification. Then in the rate notification, there are two important definitions which have come across multiple references and discussions on other platforms also, are civil structures and structure. So, and why it is important to firstly see which notification you are covered, which serial number you are covered, is because otherwise then you are falling under a residual entry, which says the rate of tax is 18%. Otherwise, if it is falling under the entry that we are trying to cover today, the rate is 12%. So let us see what all we can cover, and then I'll invite in between Anilji and Pavanji for their views on certain topics. Let me take you through this then. So firstly, we're talking about Article 243G. Article 243G basically empowers the state to endow functions and powers to panchayats. And for the broadly, if you say, they say for economic development and social justice is one area that panchayat can work under. And then again, they have referred to our Schedule 11, where there are 29 such functions listed where municipality can function, and those are the, the panchayat can function. So if we'll take you through 11 schedule. So these are the list of areas that have been given and earmarked for panchayat, and these are the areas broadly that they have to function accordingly. Now we come to Article 243G of the Constitution. Now Article 243G refers to municipalities. Municipalities, again, they have endowed, they have empowered the state to empower again the municipalities with certain functions that they specified have to do, because these are third tier of government. If you see the structure, there is central government, there is state government, and then this is the third tier of structure that we are discussing. The third tier of structure consists panchayat and municipalities under. So the state is empowered through the constitution to further empower and enable these municipalities to function as self-governments. So again, the area that they are working broadly on is economic development and social justice. And then again, in 12 schedules, they have been defined that there are 18 such areas where municipalities have exclusive right to function. What additionally is there in 243G, which was not there in 243W and not in 243G, is basically committees and authorities. Now, these committees and authorities are authorities which can be set up by the state to carry on the functions enlisted in 12th schedule. So this is what basically broadly, if you refer to development authorities in your cities, development authorities in any municipalities, and Delhi Development Municipal, Delhi Development Authority, if you say Noida, which is again a development authority. So all these authorities are carved out of this particular clause of Article 243W. Then again, referring to 12th schedule, what is written in 12th schedule is what the municipality can do. So these are the functions they can do. Roads and bridges, if you see, is what you're going to refer to your clients. Then there might be promotion of agriculture in educational and aesthetic aspects. Slum improvement can also be covered there. Public health sanitization is also an area where private entities are providing services. So that is also of a concern here. We'll collate this when we move to the specific notifications and specific entries in that notification. So firstly, so this was what was covered under Article 243G and what was covered Article 243W. You will have it more collated when you refer the entries and why the importance of Article 243G and 243W. Now I invite your attention to this this definition, which is there in Section 2, Clause 119 of CGST Act, which says the work contract means this is the definition. There is nothing to be construed beyond this. This is what is works contract in GST now. It is a contract for a building. So this is one word. Then it starts with construction, fabrication, completion, maintenance, fabrication, completion, erection, installation, fitting out, improvement, and all such things related to an immovable property, wherein the transfer of property in goods, whether as goods or some other form, is involved in the execution of such contract. Now, additionally, we will analyze the definition also. I must also tell you that in Schedule 2, which is with reference to Section 7 of the CGST Act, which says that if it is a works contract which is covered under 2119, then it is a service. So if you are providing and then there is a composite contract also. Let us, we will see how that correlates differently. So let us not confuse ourselves with a work contract and a composite contract. Composite supply is something that is there in Section 8. Then you have this 2119 also, which is a works contract, which defines ki works contract kya hoga. Hum kyun works contract ko define kar rahe hain? Because yahi nature ki services cover kari hai governmental services ke under. So I would stop myself, and then I would basically invite Anil ji to share more lights on what work contract is one. And then are we reading this correctly in terms of only immovable property, because immovable property is there. Then if he could express his views and share his views on what immovable property is there in GST, and then I will invite Pawan ji to share his views. Anil ji, if you please.
Thank you, Pradeep ji. See, this works contract has been a matter of dispute since it was made a part of the constitution after Ghen and Dankarle decision, before which state government wanted to test the material going into a construction service, saying that the ownership of the material is being transferred to the person who is given the construction contract. Therefore, we will collect tax. This was the issue, and this basically started only on civil construction work, including the government contracts, where person was supplying services, mainly in the form of labor and goods, which were consumed in the such construction work. Construction services is a new concept, which came after introduction of service act. What we see in this definition of work contract, they have very clearly mentioned one word, immovable. Now the concept of immovable property goes back to division of power between union and state government much before the Constitution of India came into existence. That was Government of India Act 1935, which was later merged and expanded in the Constitution, and which carried the provisions for taxation limited to immovable property. Subsequent service tax provisions also were supposed to implement the works contract for immovable properties only, but there was a mess in 2004 where they created separate services. In 2006-07 they carved out a separate works contract service. In GST they have tried to specify the issues which were earlier we had discussed that Supreme Court held in their decision in L&T in 2015, that where there is no material supply, then if there is a service through including a material supply, it would not come under the construction of residential complex or commercial complex. It's a separate service under works contract, and it is to be taxed from 2006 onwards only. Now in GST arena, when we see that most of the service tax have been transferred to GST as it is, or it was intended that service tax which was introduced in 2012 is not disturbed much, and almost all the provisions were shifted to GST for implementation in the same intent and in the same format to the one extent. What they wanted to do in GST was that they wanted to avoid the confusion which was created before L&T Supreme Court 2015, or which was created in 2006 by introducing a separate works contract. So what they did in this is, earlier we were not familiar with the concept of composite supply. Now they have introduced a term, composite supply. Anything which involves multiple supplies, whether it is a composition of goods and goods or whether it is a composition of goods and services, would be a composite supply. Works contract is one such composite supply. Now, in the definition, when they mentioned immovable property, that means it has to be immovable property. No any other service combined with goods would go under works contract, be it purchase and fitting of air conditioner, be it purchase and fitting of any other detachable thing which is which does not become a part and parcel of the immovable property. Then they, using their powers under section 7, they defined that this composite supply of works contract would be treated as service. Whatever be the component of the material, we will treat this composite work supply, composite supply of works, this service of construction, as works contract. So immovable property, labor and material, and a forced classification as service. I don't have to now go to the principal
nature of the supply or composition of the goods ki usme 90% goods hai 10% labor hai ki 99% goods hai 1% labor hai no they said it's going to be classified under one head that is service so in all analysis whenever any situation arises we need to understand that wherever there is a mention of works contract in most of the contracts they don't mention this term see when you sign a contract when your client is signing a contract they don't mention it as a works contract they say you know construction and completion of so and so building or construction or completion of so and so road or construction and completion of any movable property for the you know sake of discussion in GST however they did one separation in services where land was getting transferred to a person during the provision of service they carved out separate classifications for such services jahan hum where we saw in the last I think second last or third last discussion where we saw the provisions relating to residential real estate projects and only real estate projects and then which are not real estate projects but are commercial projects but which are having residential units also so these things they carved out a separate category because the this at a large scale involved introduction of developers in like developers is an entity developer is an entity which is absent in government contracts in government contracts any building you make you don't get you know you don't deal with the title of the land it stays with the landowner it stays with the government authority so when we say works contract we need to understand that firstly you need to see whether it is a government contract or not if it is a private contract you need to see whether it is a residential real estate whether it is a project first of all you need to see whether it is a project if it is a project then whether it is a residential project or not there is a definition and ratio given if it is so you are out of works contract thing just forget about the works contract you go to this residential construction part of the taxation if it is not a residential real estate project then also you see whether it is a only real estate project which may involve commercial and residential both or sirf commercial bhi ho sakta hai real estate project agar waisa bhi hai aur usme developer involved hai to aap usme bhi isse bahar hain works contract se bahar hain वर्स कॉन्ट्रैक्ट अगर आपका कॉन्ट्रैक्ट गवर्नमेंट अथॉरिटी के साथ है तो 99% गुंजाइश होने वाली है जहां भी मूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी रोड होवे सड़क होवे रोड होवे चाहे डैम होवे चाहे सरकार की हवेली होवे चाहे उनका ऑफिस इज गोइंग टू बी इमूवेबल सर्विस फॉर वर्स कॉन्ट्रैक्ट फॉर रिमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी so this is a broad concept of you know definitions are very hard and fast when we go to the legal terms this was the basic understanding concluding the matter as per section 2119 is we that the core concept is we don't have to get confused with the works contract in any promoted real estate thing and to consider whether it is a works contract it has to relate to a immovable property over to Pradeep
sir everybody is asking the basic simple question is and I would request everyone to kindly post your queries in the chat box only so the issue relates to immovable property sir what is immovable property so ab in immovable property what we commonly understand is something which is attached and affixed to the earth or embedded in the earth is what the general understanding is So, is a AC centralized AC a immovable property, or such kind of properties which are installed at one location and then attain the permanency, are those also immovable properties?
Now, I think you must be referring to that decision of that lift, no?
Yes, sir.
Whether it is a part of the immovable, let us take the example of that lift.
Right.
Or Kone.
Kone lift. Or Kone elevators.
Kone elevators.
Kone elevators. Kone elevators was ultimately decided in favor of department.
Right.
Saying what? Kone elevators said, you install a lift, you replace a lift, you repair a lift. Equally, you repair a building also, but you don't remove a building.
Right.
Let us understand the difference. A centralized AC system is a removable concept. Immovable property is a very contentious term, which says in its simplest term is the land and constructions and things attached thereto or appurtenant thereto. अभी अटैच देयर टू में हमने ये देखा, एक बहुत पहले एक्साइज में सुप्रीम कोर्ट का एक डिसीजन हुआ था सिरपुर इंडस्ट्रीज का, जिसमें ये कंटेंशन आया था कि भाई ये जो मशीनरी है, प्लांट एंड मशीनरी, ये तो जमीन में फाउंडेशन बोल्ट के थ्रू लगाई जाती है और ये जमीन के साथ में अटैच्ड है, इसको मैं बिना उखाड़े बिना बर्बाद किए यहां से हटा नहीं सकता हूं। लेकिन सिरपुर इंडस्ट्री में भी उन्होंने ये बोला कि प्लांट एंड मशीनरी, जब एक्साइज का बात हो रहा था उस समय, डेफिनेशन मार्केटेबिलिटी भी थी और उसमें मैन्युफैक्चर भी था, मार्केटेबिलिटी भी थी कि आपने जब
भी था,
हाँ, जब आपने वहां प्लांट बनाया तो प्लांट एज सच वो मार्केटेबल आइटम है कि नहीं है, पहली चीज। दूसरी चीज, वो प्लांट की आइडेंटिटी उसके कंपोनेंट से अलग है तो मैन्युफैक्चर तो हो ही गया, तो आप टैक्स भरिए। यहाँ इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी में हमको फंडामेंटली ये समझना चाहिए सर कि एज एन एग्जांपल, किसी भी बिल्डिंग में जो वायरिंग है फॉर सप्लाई ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, इट इज इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी, पर उस वायरिंग से आपने कोई फैन लटका दिया, कोई एसी चलाया, कोई कंपोनेंट चालू किया, जो रिपेयर एसी लगा दिया आप, लिफ्ट लगा दिया आप, आई वुड नॉट सजेस्ट यू टू टेक रिस्क and include the lift, because Kone elevator still rules the mind of government authorities. तो उसको आप immovable property में count नहीं कीजिए। तो जब आप installation supply and installation आप lift के लिए जा रहे हैं तो आप works contracts से दूर हो जाएगी, आप कंपोजिट सप्लाई में जाइए, लिफ्ट पे पैसा भरिए क्योंकि वो प्रिंसिपल सप्लाई है, बाकी सारी लेबर इंस्टॉलेशन और उसका सजावट डेकोरेशन इंसिडेंटल है, प्रिंसिपल सप्लाई इज लिफ्ट।
राइट सर, थैंक यू। एंड आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट एवरीबॉडी टू काइंडली रीड वॉट्स कॉन्ट्रैक्ट फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ गवर्नमेंटल सर्विसेज ओनली, बिकॉज देयर इज अ रेफरेंस ऑफ इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी दो, बट इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी इज ऑल्सो रेफर्ड इन सेक्शन 17(5) फॉर द पर्पसेस ऑफ आईटीसी। So don't jump to asking question as regard to the admissibility of ITC here. We're not discussing the admissibility of ITC here today. What we're purely discussing is the nature of that service that is provided to government authorities and how they're covered in exemptions and how they're not covered in exemptions. And there were a lot of questions as regard to this thing, whether this thing is immovable property or not. If that question is answered, if you have any other question as regard to immovable property, I would invite anybody to ask that question. And one by one, if you could raise your hands and then we can take it further, your questions. Else we move on to the next part of the webinar. Anybody has any questions as regard to works contract and immovable property? I assume that it is aptly covered and explained. I would still invite your, if you have any questions, put it in the chat box. We can take it at the end. So now we move on to what is there in the notification 1, notification 11/2017 and 12/2017. So there are certain terminologies which are defined there, which is one is governmental authority. And then is government entity. Now, governmental authority, if you say, they are saying that governmental authority is, it again says means, that means this is what the definition has to be construed. There is nothing that additionally you have to imply in governmental authority. It is an authority or a board or any other body. One, it is set up by the Act of Parliament or State Legislature. Two, it is established by any act, any government, sorry. Established and set up are two different things. Set up, if you say, it basically goes through the entire process of in the parliament, an act, if you say. It is a bill, then it becomes an act, it goes for an assent to the president first and Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha president, and then it becomes an act. Similarly, it goes to the, if it is by a state legislature, the state legislature passes it, goes to the governor, then becomes, it grants an assent and becomes an act. So that is what is set up by an act of parliament. ICAI is set up by an act of parliament. Institute of Cost Accountant of India, Institute of Chartered Accountant of India is set up by an act of parliament. Then various other things, other authorities are also, Delhi Development Authority is set up by an act of parliament. So that is set up by an act of parliament. Established by any government company. If you see the Navratan companies and all, those are established by any government. So those are basically government companies. That is how we refer them in common parlance. Now, what additionally these authority, board or any body has to do, what they have to do is that established by any government with 90% or more participation by way of equity or control, this is one part that they have to comply with. Now this is an issue of contention and this is before the Supreme Court. So please, I would not conclude this matter as to what this is. What it says in Bihar, I think Commissioner Bihar imposed, there was certain issue as regard to services provided by L&T in Bihar to a government authority. So the issue came up there because the similar definitions were there in service tax period also. So the issue that came before the authority there and the department that raised the issue is that this 90% clause is applicable to both the things. That whatever board, authority or anybody that is established by the Act of Parliament or State Legislature has to comply with this 90% condition one. Secondly, the established by any government authority has to also comply with that equity control 90%. Secondly, now this authority, board or anybody also has to carry out functions which are interested in 243G and 243W. That is why the reference to Article 243G and 243W was drawn, that they should be in the nature of providing such services which are covered under Schedule 11 and Schedule 12. Then there is another definition which says government entity. Now, government entity, there is only one difference, that the functions are not entrusted here. The functions are only functions with the central government, state government, union territory or the local authority entrust on that government entity to function. So that is the basic difference between a governmental authority and a government entity. I will invite the views of the experts as to what is the differentiation between this. But this is what the primary differentiation we can see here right now. Then we move on to the next definition, which is local authority, which is defined it as panchayat, municipalities and municipal committees and all. So what basically government related services provide exemptions is provided to the recipient of services government. So government, we know it is a state government or a central government. And then they say a union territory. So union territory also we understand is like Chandigarh is a union territory, Daman and Diu are union territories. Ladakh is a union territory now. Then they come to local authorities. So local authorities are defined here. Then they say they refer to governmental authorities and government entity. So governmental authority and government entity we have seen in the previous definition. If Pavanji is there, Pavanji, if I could invite your views to this, sir. Pavanji?
सर
हाँ जी मैं जो चीज जो इशू ड्रॉ करना चाह रहा हूँ सर कि अगर किसी नोटिफिकेशन में या जो रेट अगर रिड्यूस कैटेगरी में है तो उसमें गवर्नमेंट इंक्लूड है, गवर्नमेंटल अथॉरिटी इंक्लूड है, गवर्नमेंटल एंटिटी भी इंक्लूड है, गवर्नमेंट एंटिटी भी इंक्लूड. तो गवर्नमेंटल अथॉरिटी और गवर्नमेंट एंटिटी में एक फर्क यही आ रहा है कि जो फंक्शंस है वो फंक्शंस नहीं है यहाँ पे जो गवर्नमेंट एंटिटी है.
Right.
The rest all is same.
Absolutely.
Then where do I matlab why there is a confusion and why so many advanced ruling as regard to the coverage of that body being in the definition of entity or authority? If you can share your views on that and then on the definition also, that what is covered or what is not covered. पवन जी
डिस्कनेक्ट हो गया. तब तक एक क्वेश्चन है, क्वेरी आई है जो स्टार से, वो एक देख लीजिए
सर वो ये इनकी सारी क्वेरी रिमूवल प्रॉपर्टी से रिलेटेड है, ये रिपेयर एंड मेंटेनेंस से रिलेटेड पूछ रहे हैं. उसको थोड़ा क्लियर कर चुके हैं बट लास्ट में एक बार इनको ले लेंगे.
ठीक है,
क्योंकि वी हैव शिफ्टेड फ्रॉम रिमूवल प्रॉपर्टी नाउ.
परफेक्ट.
If Anil ji can hear us.
Yeah, I can hear.
Sir, if you would like to share, I think Pavan ji is having some issues connecting.
Well, in this regard, I would just, let us first go through the legal aspects of two definitions given. There are lists. If you understand the constitution, they have given the list for union territories, they have given the list for state. And then you have these Schedule 11 and Schedule 12, which are functions of Ministry of Corporations. The functions or powers which are given to union under one list may be delegated by government to a department or an authority. Let us go to the lower part of the definition, government entity, where it says government entity means an authority or a board. Board, I am saying, let us say ordnance board. You have a factory ordnance factory board. You have a railway board.
Right.
Or any other body, including a society, trust, or corporation. After this, they gave you two parts, set up by an act of parliament or state legislature. Railway board is constituted under Railway Act. Ordnance board is constituted under the Defence of India Act. Pradhan Mantri Rahat Kosh is not constituted under parliament. It is a trust, maybe a society, I don't exactly know. But it is not a government entity. So thumb rule to identify a government entity is to see whether they are doing any function which are covered under allocation of business rules. Now, this is something very few of us might have gone through. In a recent case, I had to go through, so I also now have visibility on that part. There are Government of India business rules. Oh, Government of India business rules say this ministry will do these functions. So, in government entity, when they say the function entrusted by central government, state government, union territory, or a local authority, they are talking about those functions given to a state government or central government or union territory or local authority the best way to identify an entity, whether it is a government entity or not, is to see whether their tenders are signed in the name of president or governor or not.
Exactly.
अगर आपको उनके विज्ञापनों में नीचे लिखा दिख रहा है कि उत्तराखंड के गवर्नर दिस इज अ वेरी थंब रूल आई एम सेइंग तो वो गवर्नमेंट एंटिटी है 100% किसमें फर्स्ट पार्ट बिकॉज इट इज अ सेटअप बाय एन एक्ट ऑफ पार्लियामेंट और स्टेट लेजिस्लेचर ऑर्डिनेंस फैक्ट्री बोर्ड भी अगर विज्ञापन निकालेगा तो वो राष्ट्रपति के नाम से निकालता है दूसरा ये है कि वो कोई कंपनी बना ले समझिए कि उसमें मैं एग्जांपल आपको देता हूं कंपनी का ये एक्चुअली गवर्नमेंटल अथॉरिटी में कवर हो जाएगा आपने देखा होगा अभी बहुत सारी जगहों पर यू नो देयर इज अ कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ डेवलपमेंट ऑफ स्मार्ट सिटीज गोइंग ऑन
राइट
एंड दे हैव कॉन्स्टिट्यूटेड कंपनीज
राइट
इन द नेम ऑफ सम सच स्मार्ट सिटीज Equity is held by state government and municipal corporation and sometimes it is shared with the development authorities also. So, it is not but through an act of the parliament. Smart city may give a contract which may not be covered under the function of 243W or 243G. 243W and 243G is mostly towards the public services. Sanitation, road, water supply, health, livestock maintenance, boundaries maintenance, gram panchayat ke jo function hai, jo gram se judi hui jameen hai, jo vanopaj agar gram panchayat ke area mein aa rahi hai, uska hisab kitab dekhna. ये 243W 243G के फंक्शंस में है कुछ कुछ फंक्शन एक में होंगे दूसरे में नहीं होंगे बहुत कम आपको ऐसा मिलेगा मोस्टली वो एक ही चीज को रिप्रेजेंट करते हैं दैट इज पब्लिक हेल्थ सैनिटाइजेशन एंड पब्लिक वेलफेयर
इकोनॉमिक
पब्लिक एजुकेशन दैट्स हाउ यू फाइंड मोस्ट ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट रन हॉस्पिटल्स एंड गवर्नमेंट रन स्कूल्स फंक्शनिंग अंडर म्युनिसिपैलिटीज और ग्राम पंचायत्स So, there might be certain government entities which are established through an act of parliament or established by a state legislature through an act, but not rendering the services or not involved into 243W or 243G functions. Most of the states have at least one industrial development corporation. Industrial development corporations are established under certain provisions of Industries Act. For development of industries, it's a state function. But this function is nowhere covered under 243W or 243G. So when you are reading the exemption for government entity, we have to be sure ki wo 243W या 243G वाला है कि नहीं है क्योंकि ये क्रॉस हो सकता है दोनों में एक दूसरे का एक एक बड़े सर्कल के अंदर एक छोटा सर्कल दोनों में फर्क ये है कि छोटे सर्कल वाला दोनों जगह गिना जा सकता है लेकिन बड़े सर्कल वाला दोनों जगह नहीं गिना जा सकता है इंडस्ट्रीज डेवलपमेंट कॉरपोरेशन ऊपर वाली डेफिनेशन में नहीं आएगी लेकिन सारी अथॉरिटीज जो गवर्नमेंटल अथॉरिटीज है वो नीचे वाली डेफिनेशन में आएंगी क्यों है ऐसा मैं आपको बोलता हूँ ये कंफ्यूजन नहीं है एक्चुअली ये बड़ा देखा समझा उन्होंने वो बना रखा है कि जब उन्होंने टैक्सेशन चालू किया गवर्नमेंट सर्विसेज का तो सर्विस टैक्स में भी आपको याद होगा कुछ सर्विसेज को छोड़ के उन्होंने ये बोला कि गवर्नमेंट अगर कोई सर्विस आपको दे रही तो भाई पैसा आपको आपको भरना है रिवर्स चार्ज अगर आप गवर्नमेंट को कोई सर्विस दे रहे हो तो गवर्नमेंट से कोई सर्विस ले रहे हो तो सॉरी अगर गवर्नमेंट आपको कोई सर्विस दे रही है तो किराया छोड़ दीजिए पोस्ट इलेक्टोरल अथॉरिटीज के फंक्शन छोड़ दीजिए, कार्गो ट्रांसपोर्टेशन, पैसेंजर ट्रांसपोर्टेशन छोड़ दीजिए, बाकी सब में अगर सरकार आपको कोई सर्विस दे रही है तो आपको रिवर्स चार्ज में भरना है। अब आपको ये देखना पड़ेगा कि ये जब सर्विसेज आपके पास में आ रही हैं तो ये 243W वाली अथॉरिटी की तरफ से आ रही है, 243G वाली की तरफ से आ रही है, या बड़े वाले सर्किल की तरफ से आ रही है जो छोटे सर्किल के बाहर का हिस्सा है। रिवर्स चार्ज वहां भी लगेगा। (243W) (243G) की सर्विसेज कुछ एक्सेम्प्शन भी है ना, आप सेक्शन 12 शायद आगे जाएंगे उसमें। प्रदीप जी आप पढ़ चुके हैं क्या उससे? मैंने ध्यान नहीं दिया। एक्सेम्प्शन वाले कवर कर चुके हैं क्या हम लोग?
नहीं, उसको कवर करेंगे सर, अभी नहीं किया।
ठीक है, उसको आगे देखेंगे। पर बेसिकली द लॉजिक बिहाइंड सेपरेशन ऑफ दीज टू बॉडीज लाइज इन द एग्जम्पशन।
Right, sir.
Yes.
Thank you, sir. Pavanji, if you could also share your views, and I would request the Blue Star team to kindly collate amongst yourself the questions that you need to ask, because on a similar topic, similar questions are coming from multiple participants. So I would request that there are other matters also we need to discuss. So if one person can collate the question that you need to ask, and we can take it up, because these questions are similar to what everybody is asking. So that is a sincere request. Now, sir, staying on to this definition, Pavanji and Anilji to both, they are asking, what they are basically asking is, they have asked for IIMs and IIT, are they covered in the government authority?
IIT, mein there is a decision in case of fee. Shepurji, Kalun, G and company, there is a decision wherein they have held that IIT will constitute as a governmental authority.
Right.
Hello.
Ji sir, we can hear you, sir.
Yeah, I think there's some problem with the video. So there is a decision recently from service tax perspective. This definition was there also in the service tax regime. And in case of Shapoorji Palanji, they have constructed the administrative block for IIT. And this matter went to the court, I think, wherein it has been held that IIT will constitute as a governmental authority, as 90% it has been constituted by the Act of the Parliament and 90% control is with the government. And further, it falls within the purview of Article 243W, as education services are to be, is a municipal function. And therefore, they have held IIT to be a governmental authority. And on the similar lines, I believe AIM should also qualify as a governmental authority. And coming to the difference between governmental authority and governmental entity, I think Anilji has explained it in a very nicer way. If I look at an example which comes to my mind, what could be the governmental entity? I've seen most of the electricity boards have been constituted into companies now, and provision of electricity, urban electricity, does not fall within the purview of 243W or 243G. The rural electricity definitely is. So that could be one example of a governmental entity wherein we can distinguish, because it has also been constituted by the government with 90% control with the government. So this could be one example where I see the difference. Then again, HSIDC, again, if you look at, again, HSIDC is something, Industrial Development Corporations. They are also formed in a form of a company, or wherein, if we look at small-scale industries, that fall under the purview of Article 243G. But when we comes to the development of a larger industry or mid-level industries, that is not, that does not get covered under 243G. Again, that can again come under the purview of governmental entity and not as a governmental authority. So you need to actually see the functioning and the objective of the organization to identify whether it will qualify as a governmental authority or government entity. Now, why we need to look into is that if we look at the exemptions, I think the perspective of governmental authority becomes little wider than what we see for a government entity. So this is something which I believe is the difference between the two definitions.
Thank you so much, sir. I think that has answered the question that Blue Star team is wanting to answer. There are a lot of questions that are coming from Blue Star team. I will pick and choose the questions that are relevant to everybody else also, because we are discussing a lot of other things as well. And then one thing is that you might be providing your repair and maintenance, you might be supplying services of air conditioners to multiple agencies. So this exercise also has to be done from various angles, not purely just putting down the list of entities to whether it is or not, whether it is or not. So give us time to respond to that also. And what question I also wanted to ask my experts is one thing, sir, to both of you, that this 90% clause that it says in both entity and as well as authority, it says with 90% or more participation by way of equity or control. Though it is again, I would repeat myself that it is still in Supreme Court for to be decided, because this issue was raised before High Court Bihar and this went to Supreme Court. What that says is that this 90% clause is applicable to clause A1 and 2 both. Whereas the SSC or the applicant is saying, no, it is only applicable to the second clause. It cannot be made applicable to the first clause. So what are your views on that, sir?
Suresh, may I?
Yeah, please.
See, let us read it again. Government entity means an authority or a board or any other body, including a society, trust, corporation, one, set up by an act of parliament or state legislature. When you set anything by an act of parliament, there is no question of equity. It's a complete government authority. If it is under an act of parliament, it is going to be under central government. If it is under state legislature, it's going to be under state government. Established by any government. And I said any government means all governments. With 90% or more participation by way of equity or control, to carry out a function entrusted by the central government, state government, union territory, or a local authority. Did you notice that in the first clause, local authority is missing? Set up by an act of parliament or a state legislature.
Right.
All legislation of local authorities are done by state government. So, a government entity with 90% or more control would be like what? Like I said, a smart city. There are several smart cities where government of state has participated through either development corporation or through their own agencies, and a part is given to municipal corporation. There are certain smart city companies where higher equity is held by municipal corporation. Development of a city, a smart city, like providing complexes and to an extent residential house, smart city is like a developer. वो सरकार से लैंड मांगती है, उसके ऊपर पूरा प्रोजेक्ट डेवलप करती है, जैसे रियल एस्टेट प्रोजेक्ट डेवलपमेंट कंपनी, बट ओन्ड बाय गवर्नमेंट और कंट्रोल्ड बाय गवर्नमेंट. इट इज नॉट नो सेट अप बाय एन एक्ट ऑफ पार्लियामेंट. एनीथिंग सेट अप बाय एन एक्ट ऑफ पार्लियामेंट वुड नॉट इन्वॉल्व एनी क्वेश्चन ऑफ इक्विटी. इट इज purely under control of either state or union government. Over to Pradeep ji.
Thank you, sir. Pawan ji, if you want to share your views on that, sir. Anil ji, sir, if you can again, there's another issue in this 90% thing.
Yes.
We all know that even with GSTN, the entire earlier there was somebody else was holding certain equity. Now the government has taken control of the GISTN portal also in terms of majority of this equity control. So this happens with other boards, other companies also, that initially they are set up by the government companies where the central government or the state government has a majority stake, and then it reduces over the period of time. So this 90% has to be at the time of enactment or in continuity running through the existence.
No, sir. It has to be on the day when you are receiving or giving the service.
So that is in continuity. Matlab, it has to be there always in continuity.
Yes, 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 yes. See, one interesting question you see from some Mr. S. Vidas. Is army canteen or any central government or state government canteen fall under government entity? Corporation like Indian Oil, Steel Authority of India, VHEL, treated as government entity. See, in any body means these are bodies. There is no question.
Right.
Anybody will cover under the anybody means body. Indian Oil is not under the Act of Parliament.
No.
As is Bail. Bail is also not under the Act of the Parliament. Army canteen, yes. Army canteen is. But army canteen as a building, not army canteen as a seller. When you are giving services or building army canteen, you are giving services to government, President of India. You see your agreements, you will see that the officer is signing on for and on behalf of President of India. When you build something for army, widow, wife, welfare association, it is not. It's a separately constituted society. Maybe there may be certain government officers as post holders, but it is a separately constituted society, which is not under constitution. It is not under any act of the parliament. So therefore, it is not a government entity. So, army canteen building, yes. Army canteen supplies, no. Why? Why? Because sale is not a function entrusted by the central government. See, there is another part incorporated in the definition. To carry out a function entrusted, to whom? To the central government, state government, union territory or local authority. उनका कोई फंक्शन करने के लिए कोई कंपनी बनाई है, सरकार का कोई फंक्शन करने के लिए कंपनी बनाई है तो गवर्नमेंट एंटिटी है. सरकार का फंक्शन क्रूड ऑयल रिफाइन करके बेचना नहीं है, सरकार का फंक्शन अच्छा स्टील बनाना नहीं है, सरकार का फंक्शन कैंटीन में सामान सेल करना या फूड सेल करना नहीं. सरकार का फंक्शन आर्मी के लिए कैंटीन की बिल्डिंग बनाना है, वो प्रेसिडेंट बना के दे देंगे. अंदर जो आर्मी के वेलफेयर के लिए सेल हो रहा है, वहां फंक्शन हो रहा है, क्या हो रहा है, नहीं हो रहा है, उसका टैक्सेशन क्या होगा नहीं होगा, वो आर्मी का लोकल सीओ जाने. बिल्डिंग हम बना देंगे, बिल्डिंग प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया बनाएंगे और यू नो डिफेंस सम ऑफिशियल ऑफ द डिफेंस मिनिस्ट्री or that unit of the army will sign for an on behalf of government of India. So we have to, because why these questions are coming from Blue Star is very understandable, because they are going services to almost everybody in the country.
Right.
So when they are giving services to a smart city, they should understand that smart city is doing certain functions under 243W and not all functions under 243W.
Right.
Agar aap smart cities ke liye hospital bana rahe hain, to 12 में अभी आप जाएंगे आगे तो प्रदीप जी बताएंगे वो एग्जम्पशन है वर्क्स कॉन्ट्रैक्ट। जहां हम ब्लू स्टार की बात कर रहे हैं मेरे ख्याल से हम कंस्ट्रक्शन की बात नहीं कर रहे हैं।
They are more referring to centralized AC plants and their repair and maintenance services.
So centralized AC plant, you have to read Pune elevator. I'm afraid. I mean, this is something as on the date is still required to be resettled under GST laws.
Right.
But we need not get adventurous. Simultaneously, see, when it is on a large scale, I understand it needs a very huge cash saving or cash flow, exactly. Outflow. And every time the management needs a clarity, what is going to happen? I mean, nobody wants to say after 3 years, ki aap galti ho gayi, so therefore this 150 crore rupees demand, what can I do? I think each and every such case, they should do a proactive diligence on tax angle, which is I request all my colleagues to sensitize. GST is, you know, worst phase of the GST is yet to come. What I am going through certain investigations. I'm consulting him. Simultaneously, 4 or 5 investigations are going on large scale. What is coming out that there is a complete failure on the part of the department and there is no supportive interpretation machinery, at least to state government. So if you are registered under state government, you may have more headache. Yeah, this is an additional effect of corona. I mean, in addition to shortage of oxygen, increase of headache is going to be, you know, little more because the classification of goods is going to be one issue. And they have never handled the service tax issues. Most of these definitions pertain to mindset of service tax officers, which had their own interpretations for so many years in service tax regime. You have to have a very clear picture of your tenders. Your tenders, you know, before putting rates, you need to evaluate for which entity you are going to give the rates and quote the rates and what is going to be the consequences and to what extent you want to take risk. So there cannot be a, you know, ballpark answer to all such queries.
Right.
What I would request Blue Star is to conduct a thorough due diligence on various segments of customers, especially where there is a doubt over the, you know, the tax structure, or where there is a doubt over the reverse taxation or exemption on the tax in respect of governmental authorities. Pradeep.
Thank you, sir. Pavanji, if you have anything to add to that, sir.
So I believe what Anilji has said, that we need to really analyze in depth whenever we are working for any of the government authority or government entity, whether they will really qualify under the exemption. Definitely, we are going to elaborate on the exemptions in a later part of this conversation. But yes, it is a very, very important point that we need to establish it and review the positions and the objectives of the organization to identify whether it qualifies as a government entity or authority or not. Because at a later stage, when any investigation is initiated, the demands run into such a big number then that it becomes really difficult to cope up with such situations.
Right.
So in the past, we have seen a couple of litigations where the demands ran into like 400 crores and 450 crores.
Right.
So which becomes really larger at the later stage to handle. And even the recipient of your supplies would not be there to entertain with the exactly. demand of taxes at a later stage. So this is very critical to analyze at the very beginning when you start the contract, whether at the time of tendering itself, one needs to look into the right perspective, whether it qualifies for the exemption or not.
Thank you, sir. So broadly, what both the experts are saying and what comes out of is that we know certain agencies, so we can confidently say whether it is a governmental authority or not, whether the governmental entity or not. But respective of that, there is a question as regard to CSIR, which, if I remember, we had covered this in certain development authorities. If Anilji remembers this, I think this is not a governmental authority anywhere, which broadly we remember because it covered this somewhere. This is Council for Scientific and Industrial Research. So as of now, reading the type of entity, we don't know whether it is set up by parliament, whether it is established by any government and all. So there needs to be a thorough analysis of each of your service recipients, as Anilji also said and Pavanji said. So broadly, I think this is what we have to say as regard to governmental authority and government entity. Other than Blue Star team, if anybody has any questions, else we move on to the exemptions and rate of tax. Okay. So now we come to the exemptions. What is the exemption? What is the exemption that is provided for supply to a government, a local authority or governmental entity or an authority? So this is not services that you receive. This is basically services that you provide. Now what are the exemptions is? The exemptions are covered under notification 12/2017 and there are two serial entries, 3 and 3A. The first entry talks about a pure service. It excludes works contract and other composite supplies. So there has to be pure service. It only talks and talks of repair. Does not talk of AMC in terms of where material is also or components are also provided. This is pure service. And it is provided to, again, a government authority, state authority, union territory, local authority and governmental authority and government entity that we've covered. And then again, now this is what is important here, that you also should be the one who's providing that service in relation to 243G and 243W. So one is pure service that you have to provide under this clause and provide it to, you know, the recipient that you're talking about. And then the activity that you provide as a pure service has to be covered somewhere under Schedule 11 and Schedule 12. Secondly, they are saying in regard to supply, composite supply of goods and services. They are not referring to works contract here. It is a composite supply of goods and services. And where they say that the goods should not constitute 25% more than the value of the total contract. So in this regard, there is no reference to works contract. The reference is only to composite supply of goods and services. So there is supply of goods and there is supply of services. So again, the service recipient is central government, state government, union territory, local authority, and government entities. And then again, that activity that you're providing, the supply that you're doing, has to be in relation to, again, Schedule 11 and Schedule 12. Pavanji, if you have anything to add to this, then Anilji, and then we'll take questions as regard to this notification. Pavanji? Anil ji, aap start kar sakte hain sir.
I would request everyone's attention to the word pure. Now this pure means which is not contaminated by goods. So pure service is something pure, you know, purity is not defined anywhere in the act. This term is picked up from a notion that where there is no supply of any kind of goods and you are not charging for it. Anything which is going incidental is yours. I mean, there is no material involved in the service. Now let us understand what could be such services. One, what I can understand, the security service. It does not involve any material. Everything comes from the security service supplier. And everything is given for satisfaction of mind only. There is no material involved. Only thing is, what security? Are you providing security services to a hospital? Or you are providing security services to a mall established by a municipal corporation? Since mall does not come under 243G or W, your services will not be covered under at least this entry. Though you have provided it to a government authority or government entity, a governmental authority or government entity, but your services are not in relation to any function entrusted to a municipality or a panchayat. So again comes, while analyzing anything to do with the governmental authorities or government entities, why you have to be more cautious is because all the time their contracts are inclusive of all taxes.
Right.
Now the burden is cast upon the service provider whether there is any tax element involved or not, you ascertain and accordingly you quote the rate. I have seen so many fiascos with this exact clause, inclusive of all taxes. If you remember, there was an issue when the GST was introduced, since all the running contracts were with this clause, all taxes included. There was a deliberation among the PSUs and government agencies and government departments that an amendment to all the contracts should be introduced, that for services rendered till 30th of June, it would be inclusive of all taxes, but after June, it would be plus taxes. Minus calculation in rates for netting of the tax. कहीं वो सक्सीड हुआ कहीं नहीं हुआ, कुछ लोगों को मैकेनिज्म समझ में आया, कुछ लोगों को समझ में नहीं आया, कहीं उन्होंने किया ही नहीं और वो कॉन्ट्रैक्ट वैसे ही चलते रहे. तो जहां वो कॉन्ट्रैक्ट वैसे ही चलते रहे और जहां वो लंबे कॉन्ट्रैक्ट थे, दे आर एवरीबडी सेट्स ऑन अ यू नो बॉम्ब ऑफ एक्सपोजर बिकॉज इट्स इंक्लूसिव ऑफ एवरीथिंग. एंड इफ you are not including it in your taxable amounts, and if it is not exempted because it is not in relation to such function of 243G or W, you remain under a presumption that since it is going to government, since it is going to a municipal corporation, it will not be taxed. I am saying worst part of GST is yet to come. When GST audit team sits on your head and ask you to read these provisions and explain, क्या आपका security service mall की security में लगा था? ठीक है, municipal corporation का mall था, लेकिन exemption तो नहीं मिले. So there could be multiple such situations. Security is one example. There could be another example of say car service.
Right.
There could be another example of
legal services.
Could be legal services. Yes.
Accounting, chartered accountants.
Even this, yes, of course. So, if it is exempted, if it is exempted, you are a winner because you have given rates of all inclusive and. Maybe corporation has already taken consideration that there is a tax involvement. Right. Because the people sitting there are less skilled in interpreting the taxation provisions. They have their own laws, bylaws, building bylaws and all those. And by chance, if you claim, get an exemption, it's good. But thing is, you should know whether to claim it or not and how to claim it. And there comes along with that the issues of credit reversal and proportionate not taking the credit exclusively going into those services. So a big calculation machinery you need to establish in your system.
Right.
It is exempted. If it is exempted and you have taken the hit in your rates about the about the tax and the corporation pays it, no problem. Kisi ko pata bhi nahi chala aur tufan nikal gaya.
Right.
So this is that part. Then when they say composite supply of goods and service in which value of supply of, so there, I think this first part is I understand is over, where we are talking about pure service, where there was no supply of any goods. So we said management service, it could be security service, it could be accounting, it could be legal or such kind of service, where only intellectual or service part or labor part is only involved. But you need to see if you are providing such services, you need to see whether for what function it is being given. You could be a security service provider which is providing services to 10 establishments, and you may be exempted under only one establishment, or maybe taxable under one establishment. You need to see where you are providing services, whether you are having separate contracts for that or not. It's a long tax strategy which you need to put in place. If you are a small service provider, because it is labor pure service, if you are a small service provider, please incorporate tax in your tender rates. Unless and until आपको मालूम ही है कि नहीं साहब ये जो हमने लिया है काम सिर्फ सड़क की सफाई का है, इसमें कुछ लगता ही नहीं. जहां भी आपको ये लग रहा है कि आपकी सर्विसेज प्योर सैनिटेशन हेल्थ एजुकेशन इससे रिलेटेड नहीं है, वहां आपको एक बार एनालाइज कर लेना चाहिए सिचुएशन की कि भाई क्या करें, एग्जम्पशन लें नहीं लें, और लें तो उसको इम्प्लीमेंट कैसे करें. Now comes the second part, composite supply of goods and service in which the value of supply of goods constitute not more than 25% of the said composite supply. Saaf safai ho gayi. Saaf safai mein Dettol lag gaya, aapka floor cleaner lag gaya, maintenance ho gaya, maintenance ki service ho gayi, jisme 25% se zyada ye nahi hai, goods ka involvement nahi hai. Provided to the central government, state government or union territory or local authority or a governmental authority or a government entity by way of any function, any activity in relation to any function entrusted to a panchayat under Article 243G or in relation to any function entrusted to a municipality under 243W. Same test. मेजर सप्लाईज हटा दी इसमें. मेजर सप्लाईज हटा दी मतलब जहां भी आप कंपोजिट सप्लाई गुड्स और सर्विस की कर रहे हैं वहां पे मैं मेजर सप्लाई गुड्स की उसको बोलूंगा जहां आप एयर कंडीशनर सप्लाई कर रहे हैं. दो चीजें, एक एयर कंडीशनर सप्लाई करना, सिस्टम सप्लाई करना, और एक सिस्टम को मेंटेन करना. एयर कंडीशनिंग सिस्टम जब आप सप्लाई कर रहे हैं तो बट नेचुरली सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स का कीमत 25% से ज्यादा नहीं है, सॉरी ज्यादा ही होगा. उसका फिटिंग इंस्टॉलेशन चार्जेस, उसके मशीनरी कॉस्ट से कम होगा. लेकिन जहां आप एएमसी में जा रहे हैं, देयर यू नीड टू सी मोस्ट इन ऑल प्रोबेबिलिटी द एएमसी सर्विसेज विल नॉट इन्वॉल्व 25% ऑफ द टोटल सर्विस अमाउंट एज सप्लाई. But you need to see. I mean, if you are giving it to AMC to a hospital, not private hospital, any government or municipal hospital or state government hospital, where your services are involving less than 25% of the value of goods, whether supplied or not. Whether consumed or not, whether title passed as such or title passed in another any other form, if it is less than 25%, you are entitled to this exemption. You need to see your contract. You need to assess your business. You have to keep your billing in this ratio. One contract as a whole, आप ऐसा नहीं कर सकते हैं कि एक कॉन्ट्रैक्ट में आप 10 बार बिलिंग करें, 9 बार आप खाली सर्विसेज की बिलिंग करें एक एग्जम्पशन के लिए, और 10वीं बार आप उसको कंपोजिट सप्लाई बता के मटेरियल का बिल उसके साथ जोड़ दें। जैसे जैसे सर्विस जा रही है, जिस मैनर में जा रही है, उसी मैनर में सप्लाई को पकड़ना होगा आपको। जितने पीरियड के लिए बिल कर, पीरियडिकल बिलिंग है तो जिस पीरियड के लिए आपने बिल किया है उस पीरियड में जितना मटेरियल गया है उसी पीरियड में सर्विसेज के साथ कंबाइन करके आपको ये एग्जम्पशन लेना होगा। अगर नहीं तो नहीं, तो मैं नहीं बोलूंगा, यू मस्ट सी एन एग्जामिन व्हाट एग्जैक्टली यू आर सप्लाइंग, व्हाट एग्जैक्टली यू आर इन्वॉल्वड इनटू, व्हाट इज योर बिजनेस। प्रदीप जी,
पवन जी,
पवन जी के मैं कोई नेटवर्क इशू लग रहा आज, कनेक्ट नहीं हो पा रहे बार बार। कंटिन्यू करिए।
दिस इज व्हाट सीधे एंट्री नंबर 38 इज राइट,
3 and 3A बोचर। सो
ओके,
एनीबडी हैज एनी क्वेश्चंस एज रिगार्ड टू दीज टू एंट्रीज, आई विल टेक क्वेश्चंस एंड एल्स वी मूव ऑन टू द रेट नोटिफिकेशंस।
अनम्यूट करके भी पूछ सकते हैं आप लोग क्वेश्चन।
प्रदीप जी, हेलो
जी सर।
हाँ, जयंता फ्रॉम ब्लू स्टार। व्हाट आई वांट टू क्लैरिफाई इज दैट, बी इट प्योर सर्विस और बी इट कंपोजिट सप्लाई विद 25% ऑफ गुड्स, इफ वी एज अ ब्लू स्टार आर सप्लाइंग इट टू अ गवर्नमेंट और गवर्नमेंट एंटिटी और अथॉरिटी, शुड आवर सर्विस ऑल्सो बी नेसेसरीली कवर्ड अंडर 243GRW? I mean, we are, say suppose our, the kind of pure labor service we give is operation of AC plant. It's a pure operation, just there is no maintenance involved. Now, an operation of AC plant, because it is saying by way of an activity in relation to any function entrusted. So my activity, what I am supplying, that has also to come under 243GRW?
Yes, sir.
Or it is only the entity or authority which has to be carrying on that function?
They are not saying that the entity which is entrusted by the function. They are saying that service that is provided, that should be in relation to that function. So that means that your service that you are providing should be in relation. If you are providing any services in relation to sanitization, public health, irrigation, water treatment, that is in relation to 243W and G. So that is okay. Installation of AC is nowhere in relation to any of these services. So that is not included here.
Can we get a comment on this from Mr. Mishra?
Yeah, please, sir.
NG, you just see 3-4 words in the first part of this table. By first part and second clause, by way of any activity in relation to any function entrusted to a panchayat or municipality. Now, function entrusted to panchayat and municipal corporation is suppose health services. I understand where we are. Am I leading in a right direction?
Yes.
So there is a hospital. Suppose there is a hospital. Suppose there is a large municipal hospital. So large municipal hospital is providing service to citizenry or the localites or health services. Is it supposed to provide those health services in an air-conditioned environment? No. This is an added comfort they are providing to the residents, that they are making their hospitals air conditioned. Municipal corporations are not obliged to provide air conditioned environment to hospitals, to educational institutes, to butcheries, to to gardens, to restaurants, anything which they are doing under Schedule 12 does not mention providing such facilities or services or doing such function under air conditioned environment. Now, we need to understand that this is an incidental. There could be an argument that इसके बिना हम काम नहीं कर सकते, पानी की सप्लाई के बिना अस्पताल काम नहीं कर सकता, तो मैं पानी की सप्लाई का मेंटेनेंस का काम कर रहा हूं तो पानी की सप्लाई में एग्जम्पशन जो मैं काम कर रहा हूं मिलेगा कि नहीं मिलेगा? वाटर सप्लाई इज म्युनिसिपल फंक्शन स्पेशली मेंशन. आप ड्रिंकिंग वाटर सप्लाई के लिए काम कर रहे हो, आप हॉस्पिटल की पानी सप्लाई के लिए काम कर रहे हो, आपको वो एग्जम्पशन मिलेगा बशर्ते 25% से नीचे रहे. लेकिन अगर आप उसमें कोई बहुत बड़ा तंत्र नहीं है, आप शेड्यूल 12 की सर्विसेज देखिए, उसमें से जो भी सर्विस एयर कंडीशन एनवायरनमेंट के बिना नहीं हो सकती, जैसे मैं आपको एक एग्जांपल देता हूं कि आप, मैं एक कोरोना वायरस की लैब मैंने बनाई है, वो बिना एयर कंडीशनिंग के काम नहीं कर सकती. मैं दिल्ली म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन ने एक कोरोना वायरस चेकिंग की लैब बनाई, वायरस का इंक्यूबेशन जो टेस्टिंग के लिए जरूरी है बिना एयर कंडीशन एनवायरनमेंट में नहीं हो सकता सर, उस पर्टिकुलर काम के लिए आपको एग्जम्पशन मिलेगा. आपको प्रूव करना पड़ेगा कि वो जो फंक्शन डिस्चार्ज कर रहे हैं दैट इज इनवेरिएबली अंडर 243W और 243G एंड इट दिस फंक्शन कैन नॉट बी रेंडर्ड विदाउट यूज ऑफ दीज सर्विसेस. Am I making myself clear, Jain ji?
Yeah, so sir, the conclusion which we can draw here is that even if the supply of service is a pure service and it is given to a governmental authority or an entity, if my supply is not coming under that 243G or W, I am not entitled to the exemption. If I am not able to prove.
Yes. Right.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yes.
Anybody else has any question, or we can move on to the next slide? Okay, we move on. Next, we will take your questions in the end if there is sufficient time. Now we come to the rate notification. So there are only two exemptions in relation to the supply that is provided, and that has been discussed in detail. Now what we are coming is to rate. Now there are only two rates which I have covered here, which regards to services provided. I have not covered any rates which are in relation to construction of any residential project, to a government housing housing scheme, any of those. I have covered only which are general services. So now first supply that I have covered is under entry number 36 of notification 11/2017. So what it says is, now it says the supply is a competitive supply of works contract. So the works contract has come in play here, what we had discussed initially, as in relation to an immovable property under section 2119. Now service is by way of construction, erection, commissioning, installation, completion, fitting out, repair, maintenance, renovation and alteration of what? There are three types of resultant product defined. The first resultant product is a civil structure or an original works. With that also, what they have said is that it should not be used by that authority it should be used for other than commerce, industry or business or profession. Now they have given an explanation ki the business here will not include such business which is carried on through an government entity. So that service is, if that function, that business is carried on through a government entity, so that business is not covered here. So that is not covered here means the civil structure that is provided in relation to that government entity, that services provided in relation to a civil structure belonging to that government entity is covered under the exemptions. So then there is a civil structure that it talks, and then civil structure in relation to what? An educational, clinical, art or cultural establishment. Then it talks about a residential complex, which is for self-use of the employees, and this schedule, para 3, schedule 3 relates to MPs and MLAs and all. So now there are two important definitions and two important aspects that are coming out here is, one, a civil structure, and secondly, a structure. So I don't think there is anybody better than Anilji to explain what a civil structure is, because he himself is a civil engineer. So I will again invite Anilji to share his views on what this civil structure and this structure means here. Sir.
Sir, you see, when I did my engineering, I was not aware whether there is going to be any legal difference in any structure or civil structure. But after having experience in interaction with the departmental authorities, these laws and all, I understand the question is basically can be answered by your accountant. How this structure is being accounted? If in your asset table you are taking this to a building, if you are accounting the expenses under the building, if the government is accounting the expenses under the head of building, it is a civil structure. Road is a civil structure. Bridge is a civil structure. Dam, canal is a civil structure. Building is a civil structure, which invariably is constructed on a foundation undetachable. Plant and machinery is evaluated and accounted separately. And you can differentiate, I mean, with this civil structure and the structure accordingly. If it is accounted under plant and machinery, it is simple and a structure. If it is accounted under building, then it is a civil structure. And building would include the road and dams and bridges and canals.
If it is plant and machinery, sir, is it covered here? Can
plant and machinery is not civil structure, sir.
No, I mean to refer to the clause B, where structure is defined.
A structure means predominantly for use as an educational, a clinical, an art or cultural establishment. All structures are not civil structures. But all civil structures are structures. जब ये structure बोल रहा है तो by way of construction, erection, commissioning, installation, completion, fitting out, repair, maintenance, renovation or alteration of, by way of fitting out a structure, can it mean a building? No. It is not building. It cannot be. When I say by way of installation of a structure, it cannot be building. So it's all structures.
So it is
anything.
All structures.
Yes, anything which is part of a structure, anything which is accounted as a structure, and is for an educational or clinical or cultural establishment, it will come under this part.
Thank you, sir. So if your nature of services are covered under this, the rate is 12%. We'll cover one more, two more entries, and then take your questions in this respect. So next entry, then there is an explanation also that said, what the explanation is, ki business, jo business bola hai unhone, ki should be for other than commerce in business. So that business does not include an activity that is undertaken through a public authority. Now, though public authority has not been identified or defined in the act anywhere, what a public authority can be are listed here, which is commonly what we were discussing under the government authority and government entity provisions also. So this is broadly what a public authority can be understood as. Now we come to 3.7, which says again for composite supply of works contract, and it is provided to a central government, state government, that is there, the recipient is same. But what it says is it involves predominantly earthwork that is consisting more than 75% of the value of the contract. So this is purely related to the earthwork, excavation and all those activities. So in that case, the rate is 5%. So composite, construction, alteration and everything is covered under 3.6. And 3.7 covers the excavation and all digging and all related services. Now, there is another rate which is for subcontractors, where the main contractor is providing the services to governmental, local authority, government or governmental authority and government and entity. So in that case, if the main contractor is falling under 3.6, as a subcontractor also you'll be covered under 3.6, the rate will be 12%. If the main contractor is covered under 3.7, the subcontractor will also be covered under 3.7 at the rate 5%, providing services to that main contractor. So with this is the rate that has defined. Now we take your question in regard to these rate notifications and the entry in the rate notification. If anybody has any questions as this regard.
Yeah, Pradeep ji, I have two queries, I think, which will be from the Blue Star team as well. First of all, in the clause A, a civil structure or any other original works. Now, since we are saying that we are doing construction, erection, commissioning of HVAC plant, so say suppose it is established that we are giving it to a government entity or an authority. Now, HVAC plant by itself is not a civil structure, but it will get covered under original work. Because there is this, in the definition of original works, we have this, that erection, commissioning and installation of plant machinery or equipment prefabricated or otherwise. Is that understanding correct?
Sir, where are you reading the definition of original works?
I think it was given somewhere in, let me tell you. I think it was given and it was explained during service tax.
Yeah. So there is no definition of works.
I think we can extend that to here also, because since it is not specifically defined under G, I would like Mr. to kindly clarify that. And I will just add to that. How to determine that the recipient is not using it for commerce, industry, business or profession? Should we be assuming by default that any governmental authority or government entity is not a profit-seeking organization? Because, I mean, these are things which are very difficult to understand, whether there is a business motive or a commercial, it is being run for commercial purpose or not.
So the very nature of your recipient will define, and if you go and look into the basic constitution of that entity. So what they have said, one part is, if it is through a government entity, which we have already identified in the previous definition, what a government entity is. So if it is through that is covered here in this rate notification. And other than that, If it is not a government entity, which is either established by an act of parliament or the state legislature, or established by the government with 90% control, and then carrying out the functions of central government, state government, local authority, and if that is the entity we are talking about, that is covered here. Any other entity that is not covered here. This is what my understanding is.
If I may?
Yes, sir, please.
If I have a printout of this very entry, 3.6, where by an amendment the term local authority, governmental authority, or a government entity is added to the words central government, state government, union territory. 3-6 we are discussing.
Yes,
right?
Yes, yes. That part I'm not covered here, sir, because the service recipient is the same in all the cases.
Now, as far as query of Jayanji is concerned, Jayanji ka question tha.
Hanji, hanji.
See, original works ka jo aap definition service tax mein lete the, aap usko lekar hi chaliye. Kyunki agar inhone yahan define kiya hua hai, but naturally, jaisa what we discussed was that lock, stock, barrel, they tried to, you know, transport service tax provisions into GST, and drafting of GST laws is still in the stage of improvement day by day. I mean, it was not a one-time measure to shift everything. So they transported almost all the provisions. Certain things subsequently arise and they keep on amending the covered entities or keep on amending the definitions. But as far as original works is concerned, you can very well take the original works which was defined in service tax earlier to be covered under this entry also. Because what courts say, what judiciary says, any word in any statute is not meaningless. If they have written original words, they must mean something which has something to do with the original word, defined or undefined. If it is defined elsewhere, you have to take that definition. I mean, there is no harm in understanding the entry with the help of earlier service tax laws. What issue it could result in, I could not hear you properly, Jayanji. How is it making a difference?
Sir, my question was that HVAC plant, installation commissioning of a HVAC plant will not qualify as a civil structure. But it will fall under original works because
it will fall under original works. Bilkul sahi
hai. So that point is clarified. And then I was putting this thought ke whether this commercial or business purpose of that government entity or authority, how to determine that?
नहीं, आपको सर वो एंटिटी का नेचर समझना पड़ेगा. देखिए, अगर वो स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट और म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन के अलावा है कोई गवर्नमेंटल अथॉरिटी, तो आपको उसका मैंडेट समझना पड़ेगा. उस अथॉरिटी को मैंडेट क्या दिया गया है. उस मैंडेट में अगर वो कॉमर्स या इंडस्ट्री, मतलब जैसे आप समझिए, मैं बात कर रहा था आपसे कि सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट का कोई एक हॉस्पिटल, समझिए, आई डोंट नो, सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट बना सकती है, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट बना सकती है, म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन बना सकती है. म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन ने एक हॉस्पिटल बनाया और वो सिविल स्ट्रक्चर नहीं है. चलिए, बहुत हाइपोथेटिकली हम लोग इसको ले जाने की कोशिश करते हैं एब्सर्डिटी की लिमिट तक, समझने के लिए कि ऐसा हॉस्पिटल बनाया जो मेकशिफ्ट है, सिविल स्ट्रक्चर भी नहीं है.
कोविड के टाइम पे बनाए जा रहे हैं.
हाँ, तो वो सिविल स्ट्रक्चर भी नहीं है. अब उसी मेडिकल फैसिलिटी के लिए जो स्ट्रक्चर उन्होंने बनाया है, उसके बाहर उन्होंने दवा बेचना भी शुरू कर दिया. नाउ दिस हैज बिकम अ मोर कॉम्प्लेक्स. दवाई बेचना इनके फंक्शन में नहीं है, लेकिन अंदर जो मरीज हैं उनका इलाज करना इनके फंक्शन में है. अब वो जो अंदर इलाज हो रहा है, वो तो ना कॉमर्स है, ना इंडस्ट्री है, ना बिजनेस है, ना प्रोफेशन. लेकिन बाहर का जो शॉप है, जहां दवाई बिक रही है, जहां इंस्ट्रूमेंट बिक रहा है, दैट इज अ प्योरली कमर्शियल पार्ट. Of that, I'm, you know, we are talking to the extent of absurdity. This example may go further. कि
उसी दुकान के बाजू वाली दुकान में मेकशिफ्ट हॉस्पिटल के बाजू वाले हिस्से में जो खाली पड़ा है उन्होंने वहां पर फेस मास्क बनाना चालू कर दिया, चार आदमी बिठा ले और कपड़े सिलवाना शुरू कर दिया, फेस मास्क या पीपीई किट बनाने लगे। आपका ओरिजिनल वर्क्स है, आपका जो इंस्टॉलेशन है वो चूंकि पूरे मेकशिफ्ट स्ट्रक्चर के लिए है तो ओरिजिनल वर्क्स भी है, मेकशिफ्ट स्ट्रक्चर भी है। अब आप प्रीडोमिनेंस शब्द का देखिए कहाँ यूज आता है, मीट प्रीडोमिनेंटली फॉर यूज अदर देन कॉमर्स इंडस्ट्री और अदर बिजनेस और प्रोफेशन। अगर अंदर चार बेड्स लगे हैं और बाहर की दवाई की दुकान 400 स्क्वायर मीटर की है तो वो प्रीडोमिनेंटली बिजनेस के लिए यूज हो रही है, हेल्थ पर्पस के लिए नहीं। आप ये बड़ा सब्जेक्टिव इशू है, आपको हर बार ये देखना पड़ेगा कि हम किसको सर्विस दे रहे हैं, पहली चीज। दूसरी चीज, वो जिसको हम सर्विस दे रहे हैं उस एंटिटी का मैंडेट क्या है, क्या बिजनेस करना उसका मैंडेट है। अगर आप स्मार्ट सिटी लिमिटेड को सर्विस दे रहे हैं, बिल आपका वहीं से आ रहा है और स्मार्ट सिटी एक अस्पताल चला रही है तो वो एक कंपनी है जो एक अस्पताल चला रही है, वो एज ए कंपनी एक अस्पताल चला रही है, एज एन एंटिटी उसका प्रीडोमिनेंट काम अस्पताल चलाना नहीं है, उसका प्रीडोमिनेंट काम जो है वो सिटी डेवलपमेंट। आपके स्ट्रक्चर का प्रीडोमिनेंट काम देखना है आपको एंटिटी के बजाय, पहले तो ये देखिए कि आपका जो स्ट्रक्चर है, जो ओरिजिनल वर्क्स हो चाहे सिविल स्ट्रक्चर हो, उसका यूटिलिटी प्रीडोमिनेंटली किस चीज के लिए।
सर ये कैसे पता लगेगा, मतलब वी हैव टू गो थ्रू द ऑब्जेक्ट क्लॉज?
ना नहीं नहीं सर, आपको थंब रूल से ही पता चल जाएगा। अगर आप म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन के मॉल के अंदर एक छोटा सा क्लिनिक में कोई सर्विस दे रहे हैं तो प्रीडोमिनेंटली वो मॉल है। If it is a centralized air conditioning system, let us be very specific for the services. तो वो जो स्ट्रक्चर है जो आपने लगाया है जिसमें 300 कमरों में सप्लाई हो रही है, जिसमें से एक ही कमरा क्लिनिक है, बाकी 299 कमरे जो है वो दुकान है, तो वो प्रीडोमिनेंस आपको परसेंटेज से देखनी पड़ेगी सर। You have to see the ratio. And you have to, if you have any doubt, you have to get a clarification from first from the entity to whom you are giving the business, who is giving you the business. And secondly, if you are still having a doubt, you must write a letter to the department before availing the exemption or any beneficial rate. This is a standard operating procedure where, you know, there are certain times, there are times in business where you face very tough competition, you understand that you cannot give it under 18%. If you calculate your rates under 18%, you may not get a beneficial rate. So you want to calculate it by 12%, but before that you have to have a very clear understanding of predominant use of your structure. Pradeep.
Thank you so much, sir. If yes,
yeah, Pradeep ji, the one additional point is the confusion about whether in case of a government entity, whether the work has been entrusted by central government or blah blah blah.
Now, no. Here, there is no such condition.
No. If
there is, see what it says is, I'll again put it for others also. It says predominantly it should be used for other than commerce industry or any other business or profession.
No, that point is I understood.
Sir, for others also, sir, please. So business here, what they have said is it excludes that business which is carried on by a central government, state government, local authority, union territory through a public authority. So like the example sir was giving, if that shop that is operated outside is operated by a government entity, so that is covered under this exclusion, because they have pulled out बिजनेस में क्या यहाँ पे कवर नहीं होगा, वो हम वो बोल रहे हैं अदर देन बिजनेस है, पर ऐसी कोई एंटिटी जो सर ने पहले स्टार्टिंग में बोला था कि ये गवर्नमेंट अथॉरिटी, सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, यूनियन टेरिटरी, किसी एंटिटी के थ्रू वो काम करा रही है, तो वो एंटिटी गवर्नमेंट एंटिटी है, तो वही गवर्नमेंट एंटिटी को उन्होंने यहाँ से कार्व आउट करके एग्जम्पशन में कवर किया है इनडायरेक्टली। आई होप आई एम क्लियर सर।
सर आई स्टिल हैव वन कंफ्यूजन, जस्ट वांट टू गेट इट क्लेरिफाइड। ये दिस प्रोविसो प्रोवाइडेड दैट वेयर द सर्विसेज आर सप्लाइड टू अ गवर्नमेंट एंटिटी दे शुड हैव बीन प्रोक्योर्ड बाय द सेड एंटिटी इन रिलेशन टू वर्क एंट्रस्टेड टू इट बाय द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट।
राइट,
नाउ कंटिन्यूइंग विद आवर एग्जांपल ऑफ इलेक्शन कमीशनिंग इंस्टॉलेशन ऑफ एचवीएसी प्लांट एंड इट इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड वी आर गिविंग इट टू अ गवर्नमेंट एंटिटी एंड वी ऑल्सो अंडरस्टैंड दैट इट इज नॉट फॉर अ कमर्शियल पर्पस दैट एंटिटी इज बीइंग रन। नाउ how to understand this entrusted part of it is that that entity is entrusted by the government to carry out certain things. How do we deduce that for to carry out that function this HVAC plant thing is also required? I mean, because in most of the cases the customers are not giving anything in writing that the work has been entrusted by the government. We do not have any credible proof to ISO is being adhered to. So how do we go about that?
Sir, see, where they are put a condition, proviso. They are, in that proviso, they are saying government entity. They are not saying governmental authorities. Now, what is a government entity? Last thing what we understood was whether their papers are signed for and on behalf of President of India or Governor of the state. One. Second, whether it is a company established to carry out तो फंक्शन ऑफ एलोकेशन ऑफ बिजनेस रूल्स वो उस मिनिस्ट्री का काम है कि नहीं या उस डिपार्टमेंट का काम है कि नहीं। पर जैसे आप ने कहा तो मैं एक एग्जांपल को आपके साथ मिलके कॉम्प्लिकेट करना चलो चालू करते हैं हम तो हमको समझेगा। आपको एक ऐसा डिपार्टमेंट बताइए जो जिसमें वो कंपनी हो IRCTC के लिए समझिए आपको सर्विस दे रहे। अब IRCTC आई डोंट नो वेदर इट इज अंडर एन एक्ट ऑफ पार्लियामेंट और स्टेट लेजिस्लेचर बट इट इज डूइंग कमर्शियल बिजनेस। आई एम सॉरी दिस इज एनी वे रिलेटेड टू ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफ पैसेंजर विच इज चार्जेबल टू टैक्स। कैन यू गिव मी एन एग्जाम्पल जयंती जहां ये कंफ्यूजन आ रहा है तो वी विल टेक दैट एग्जाम्पल ऑन।
Sir, say suppose Central Drug Research Institute.
Central Drug Research Institute, is it a society?
It is not a society, but it is. I believe it is established by the government. We have dilemma on that.
No, sir. This has been a question everywhere. Someone asked for the CSIR, someone asked for the AIIMS, someone asked for this. You know, you are saying Central Drug Research Institute. Now this, if it is a society, of course it is the control or even if it is a company or corporation, I am sure the control is with the central government. JNG?
It should be. I mean, the going by the composition of the there, it is not very black and white mentioned. I mean, what it does, sir. I think Lokesh is here. Lokesh, can you say? Hello?
Anil sir. Hello?
Yes.
Sir, can we cut short the discussion because it's already 1:30.
Pradeep ji, aap chahe to Blue Star team ke questions le lijiye, specific.
Personal, yes.
And then we can separately answer.
Yes.
Sir, for Blue Star team, if you go to that institute's, that's like, for example, you were talking about Central Drug Research Institute. If you go to the site of that institute, there is a profile and organization structure also, and the profile stays. Just that a premier drug research institute of India was inaugurated, and it nowhere says that there is a control of central government or a state government. So likewise, you can identify whether what that entity is, sir, just for an example point of view.
Pradeep ji, one last point before you close. ये चीज जहां पे ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट लिखा नहीं है और कस्टमर लिख के नहीं दे रहा है इन राइटिंग, कैन वी गो बाय द ऑब्जेक्ट क्लॉज एंड ड्रॉ द कंक्लूजन?
सर, वेरी सब्जेक्टिव, आई वुड नॉट आंसर इट टू योर सेटिस्फेक्शन, बट यू स्टिल हैव टू डिग इन अ बिट एज रिगार्ड वेदर दे आर फॉलिंग अंडर अ गवर्नमेंट एंटिटी, गवर्नमेंट अथॉरिटी और नॉट.
उनका फंक्शन होना चाहिए. सर, आप एक चीज का ख्याल रखिए कि सरकार हो, सरकार का इंस्टीट्यूट हो, सरकार की सोसाइटी हो, सरकार का ट्रस्ट हो, उसका फंक्शन डिफाइंड होना चाहिए आपके स्टेट लिस्ट में या यूनियन लिस्ट में, और उस डिपार्टमेंट को वो फंक्शन अलोकेट होना चाहिए. अगर आपको लगता है कि आप का सर्विस सिर्फ उनके समझिए ड्रग रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट ने कोई डिपार्टमेंटल स्टोर बनवा रखा है अपने मेंबर्स के लिए और आपका प्लांट सिर्फ वहीं के लिए लग रहा है, आपको कंसेशनल रेट या एग्जम्पशन नहीं मिलेगा. आपको एंटिटी नहीं देखनी है, आपको जो देखना है कि वो जो आप काम कर रहे हैं वो उनका काम है कि नहीं है. वो उनका काम है तो निश्चित रूप से आप यहाँ कवर्ड है. इंटरेस्टेड मींस जिनको उस काम करने की अथॉरिटी दी गई है, उन पे विश्वास जताया गया है कि आप ये काम करेंगे और उसमें आप पार्टिसिपेट करें.
थैंक यू सो मच सर. आई थिंक विद दिस वी कैन कंक्लूड. इट्स ऑलरेडी 120, एंड रीचिंग अ 2 hour. वी जनरली हैव अ लिमिट ऑफ 1 hour 30 मिनट्स टू कंक्लूड दिस, एंड I know the topic is of such importance to everybody that it is deliberated so long. I again thank Anil ji, Pavan ji, and all other participants who have attended, and especially the Blue Star team, those who have come in numbers for this particular topic. And
thank you very much.
We also have, I think, Menon sir here today. Sir, very welcome to this webinar. I think you are attending for the first time, sir. Sir, I think Kuch is not responding. Anyways, Jivanji, we can conclude it here, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Presentation hata diye.
Haan ji. Baki, matlab. वैसे कंक्लूड हो गया है सर, किसी को और बात करनी है तो उसमें कोई दिक्कत नहीं है.
चलता रहेगा सेशन, चलता रहेगा.
लंच के लिए जाना है सर, जाइए.
मतलब ऑल ऑफ यू,
वी आर नॉट होल्डिंग
पवन जी का. हां, थैंक यू वेरी मच टू ऑल ऑफ यू.
थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक यू सो मच.
वंडरफुल सर.